Hey, I'm Alan Frank. I'm the vehicle designer at Criterion Games.
What are you showing here at Gamescom with Battlefront 2?
So what we're showing today is the Fondor dock demo. So that is the Rebels trying to take down an Imperial Star Destroyer that's currently docked at a shipyard.
So talk about what you learned from Star Wars Battlefront that you've applied and made better vehicle-wise in Battlefront 2.
So what we found with the vehicles from Battlefront 1 is that the controls were really easy to sort of get into and quite accessible, but there was no element of mastery to it. It was like you'd play it for a few hours and then it would just be like, you know, down to your own personal skill. What we've tried to introduce in this one is we've completely redesigned all of the controls and the way that the vehicles actually handle. So they're still quite easy to sort of not get accessible. But there's quite a deep layer of mastery in there as well. So there's a good level to really be that Star Wars pilot ace that, you know, you've always wanted to be.
So in the first Battlefront, the vehicles were random spawns. Are they the same way in Battlefront 2?
No, so you obviously pick whichever vehicle that you want to go in. And then the way we do it in this one is we sort of bring you in little flights of four. So you all come in together as a group to kind of really make you feel like you're part of a squadron, you're part of a team trying to do an objective.
What are some of the challenges when designing a game that has such a multitude of different vehicles? Because, I mean, you're playing a first-person shooter, and when you get into a vehicle, it's almost a completely different experience.
So again, what we've done in this one is we've introduced an element of like class-based ships. So it was simply a choice of going through, like, you know, what are the iconic vehicles from Star Wars that we can put in? You know, your X-wings, your A-wings, your Y-wings, your TIE fighters, and basically going, where do these fit into the game? And how can we give them their own unique sense of gameplay to really make them fit that role? So that when you get into the TIE Interceptor, you know, hey, I'm the fast agile one that, you know, is really good at dogfighting. Or if you get in the Y-Wing, you're like, right, okay, I'm going to be quite objective focused and go on these bombing runs to really help my team.
So talk about the ships you're showcasing here at the demo.
Okay, so we've got three ships beside, light and dark. So we've got X-Wings, A-Wings and Y-Wings for the Rebels. So a fighter, an interceptor and a bomber. And then for the Imperials, you've got the TIE Fighter, the TIE Interceptor, and the TIE Bomber. So you've got a fighter class, an intercept, and a bomber class for both sides. And then we've got four hero ships, two for each side. So for the light side, we've got Han's Millennium Falcon, which is like a big, brawly tanker. And then we've got Poe Dameron's Black One. So he's got like some cool abilities and stuff to really help your team and be that squadron leader. And then for the dark side, we've got Slave One, who's making a return. So we've made some new additions to that, like he's got a seismic charge from the movies. And we've got Darth Maul's Scimitar, which is like a good hit and run ship. It's got a cool cloaking device. It's good gameplay.
How do you go about balancing all these ships so they're on an equal playing field? Because, you know, in the universe, TIE fighters don't have shields.
So we play test. We get a general feel for this ship's not really balanced against this ship. So we kind of use our judgment to try and make them fair. We also get a lot of metrics on what the ships are actually doing, and we combine the two together to make sure that we're getting the nice balanced gameplay that we want.
When does the game come out and what platforms will it be on?
So it's on Xbox, PS4, Xbox One, PS4 and PC. It's out November 17th, pre-order. It's November 14th, and EA Access members get it on November 9th.